Hey guys, so today is not like my typical video that I would make. It's not really like a happy video either. Instead, it's more kind of like a speaking out video. Hopefully, speaking for someone who can't speak for themselves. And honestly, when I look back at the situation that I'm in now, maybe I wish I had someone that has been through the same thing as me. They came out and spoke about it to everyone to hear.
Rising like the smoke, you linger on me. You got me so high, I can finally breathe. Your walking poetry, it's what you do to me, it's what you do. Tell me.
This video is to basically just aware people when you need to cut off connections with people that are completely toxic for you. So, I'm not gonna tell the full story because that's really like unnecessary. And honestly, though, me telling the story and getting revenge on this specific person won't do anything to help the mental damage they have caused to me. 2 years ago, I met someone who literally turned my world upside down. And you know when you get into a relationship with someone, any type of relationship, boyfriend, girlfriend, friend, when you first meet them, they're the only person that you want to be with. You're literally connected like this. And you start letting small things go, small things that would bother you go, and you try to be cooperative to this person because you care so much about them. And I think we've all been in the situation where, you know, you want to say something, but you just don't want to have like an argument with that person. But honestly, now that I look back, that's where you start the foundation of a relationship, no matter who it's with, you know? If you start letting small things go, bigger things will start to come. And it'll be harder for you to come out and say, hey, this is bothering me. For example, I found, man, this was 2 years ago. I found a mascara in the car and it really fucking bothered me just because we were together and I wasn't seeing anyone else. I knew it wasn't my mascara because I didn't use that brand and I kind of just pushed it under the rug. I kind of brought it up, but like, I never said anything to like defend myself in a way, but those small things, when those small things start building up, specific people start to take advantage of you and start to control you. So this person I was literally obsessed with, crazy in love with. And just like how I am with any relationship that I have, like my friends, anything, my heart when I first met this person was full. Like, I could give you everything you want because I was never hurt before. I had no reason to not love this person unconditionally, you know? I need to get sad. When you care so much about somebody that outside people know that they're bad for you, you start to make excuses for them. And for this specific person, I made every fucking excuse I can find to protect them. Only thing I asked, I never asked for gifts. I never asked for anything. Never asked for shit. And if I did ask for something, it would be like, I'll pay you back later. A super big favor. I'll do a favor for you back. Like, you know, my mom always taught me, you do good things and good things happen. And no. So, I'm trying to not, like, get emotional, like, once again. I tried helping this person tremendously with anything they needed, you know, like, so, I tried doing everything for this person. Anything this person needed, I tried doing for them. Anything to make this person happy, I was more than happy to go out and do for this person. Only thing I asked from this person was to be honest with me. I never asked for anything. Only thing I wanted was to be honest. If you wanted to hang out with A, B, and C, that's totally fine. I don't care who they are. If you want to hang out with them, go ahead. Go ahead. The only thing I wanted was honesty and loyalty. That's the only thing I fucking asked for. Only thing I've ever asked for. And people, what really upsets me is people have the story twisted. The thing is, if you were not in my shoes, you would not understand what I fucking went through. And whatever. So, May rolls around, and there's like shit that's happened between that, but that's not even the point of the story and why I'm telling the story. This is to help someone who has been through a mentally, emotionally abusive relationship. And whatever, May rolls around, and it was really sketchy because we would always hang out on Friday nights, and this Friday I got out extra early from school, so I was like, we can hang out all day. I was so fucking excited. Like, honestly, I was with this person for 2 years, and every single time I saw them, it felt like the first time of me meeting them, like, you know. So I remember this day like it was literally yesterday. I'm pretty sure it was like May 12th or something, or like May 11th. It was that Friday, and they told me that they can't hang out, and I was like, wow, this like sucks, whatever. But they said they were hanging out with their dad, so I was like, have fun, whatever, like, you know. So I decided to hang out with my friends. My friends who I never saw anymore. Friends that I was told that I really could not see anymore. I hung out with my friends that night, and guys showed up. And since I wasn't allowed to hang out with guys, I left. And I called this person in the car. They weren't answering their phones. Blah, blah, blah. I left. I'm like, I just want to show you how loyal I am to you. Love you so much. I know you're probably sleeping. I wish I could have seen you today. Whatever. So this specific person texts me at like 3 a.m. in the morning saying, you don't love me. I was confused. I was really confused. I'm like, no, I love you. Whatever. Next day we hang out. And that next day I found out that on that Friday that I went out, that he was hanging out with his family. I was cheated on. My heart was literally fucking squished as a bug on the floor. For some odd reason, I still tried to find the light at the end of the tunnel and look at the good in this person. I realized that a lot of people make mistakes. I've made my own mistakes, but not mistakes to genuinely fuck somebody up. And this person came to me, said that he would never do it again. So sorry, just wasn't in the right mind state, or like whatever the fucking excuse was. And I let this person back into my life. And maybe that's where I went wrong. But you know, at the time I thought it was the best thing to do. and I thought I was being pretty fair with it. So beginning of June, me and this person go to a concert, everything's fine. And then I just get completely cut off for absolutely no reason. And when I say like absolutely no reason, typically people are thinking like there has to be some reason, there had to be a fight. Nothing happened, I was just cut off. Throughout summer, on and off, this person would hit me up, let's hang out, we would hang out for one day, and then this person would completely just cut me out for 2 weeks. Within this time, this person was seeing other people, and I myself was literally just trying to heal from being so mentally fucked up at this time. So, around fall time, hit me back up, saying how they wanted to talk to me, and blah, 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 blah. This person told me that what they did was a learning experience, and, you know, I was really hurt, like, really hurt, really, really hurt. There'd be times that I would just be completely triggered by something. Walking in the store, I would see something that would remind me of the past, and I would just have to leave the store. There'd be times that I'd be sitting in class, I would just get a bad memory or start thinking about something, and I would have to leave. I would have to go to the bathroom. I would be crying my eyes out in the bathroom. And it's really just honestly scary. So we started talking again, and I was trying to take things slow, but obviously this person expected me to just go back to trusting them like how I did before. There's things within that time happened between us, but I don't know. To find out that I was not only betrayed again by someone who I looked at their mistakes and tried to always find the light at the end of the tunnel, always try to find the fucking rainbow after the storm, always try to find everything. And what I started to realize was that I've completely lost myself. Not only has this person completely brought down my confidence, tried to crush my dreams, tried to make me turn away my dreams and offers that I've had, honestly tried to make me unhappy. But basically, so it's not even the full story. But like I said, this video is to not bash on anyone, not to try to get back at someone. This is a video to possibly try to help someone who was in my situation. I'm gonna put a picture up of signs to know if you're in a mentally, emotionally abusive relationship. And honestly, it's hard to talk about this kind of stuff. And I know I'm young. I know people are gonna sit here and laugh, think it's a fucking joke. But one thing I know about myself is that I've possibly lost myself. I'm literally left with nothing. I have to take this terrible, awful experience that I've been through for the past 2 years and literally just grow from it. That's the only possible thing I can do to try to save myself. I want girls to know. I know someone's in a problem like this, and they start making excuses for their boyfriends. They don't understand why they're doing these things. They're apologizing for things that they did not do wrong. Like signs that I said of being in a mentally, emotionally abusive relationship is them blocking out your feelings. When you try to come to them and talk to them about something that's bothering you, they completely push you. I don't want to talk about this right now. I don't want this stress, blah, blah. And you are left to deal with it yourself. They lack responsibility for the mistakes they have made. If you make a mistake, we're all human. Everyone makes mistakes. But when you continue to make the same mistake and making excuses for the mistake, so you're not responsible running away from explaining your mistake, you are in an emotionally abusive relationship. Has one-sided expectations in a relationship. And this is what I mean by a hypocrite. Somebody who they can go do things, but you cannot go do things. You are in an emotionally abusive relationship. Tells you how you should dress or how you should present yourself. You are in an emotionally abusive relationship. This person ignores you or makes you feel invisible. You are in an emotionally abusive relationship. When you're with someone, you should not feel like they are ignoring you, ignoring a problem that you're having, ignoring a problem that your relationship is having. You should be able to come to that person and talk to it and not be scared of them, scared to bring it up for them to ignore you. Twist everything that you say so you are just literally completely confused. That is probably a huge thing, a huge red flag that I've had. Confused, like, turns things around that you are genuinely just so confused. You have no idea what you're talking about. You have no idea what they're talking about. And you literally just start believing the lies and the manipulation that they are causing upon you. What I realized was I started to apologize and I did not know why I was apologizing. I was apologizing to save my relationship. I was apologizing to make this person happy because I thought that was the right thing to do. I look back and realize that the mistakes I've made were me showing too much cleavage on Snapchat, me going out, hanging out with my guy friends that I've known my whole life. The thing is that it's a two-way street, you know? If any of you guys are going through an emotionally abusive problem or situation, you do not need no one. Only person you need to make yourself happy is yourself. And I wish I knew that for the past 2 years. Touch me with no hands, hold me with your eyes, unwind me with your mind tonight. Speak with no words, show me and I'm all yours. Show me and I'm all yours. All that you want, all that I need, eyes are like the smoke. I completely lost myself. I completely lost who I was. I completely, you know, I know it's still probably there inside me, deep down somewhere. It's just finding that person again, finding who I was. Never, ever in a million years did I think that I was going to go through something as crazy as this. And I know people out there have been through things completely worse, but honestly, like, my mental state is something that's so important and I feel like is pushed under the rug too many times. I'm just saying that one person in your life can change your whole outlook on a whole situation that should be looked at as something beautiful, something that's shared, something that's beautiful and something that's supposed to be shared for so many people now is ruined, is completely broke. Because I know other people are going through this, but like I said, this video is not for pity, is not for an apology, it's not for I'm sorry, it's not for you're the best, it's possibly to help that girl out there right now who's crying in her fucking bed like how I was for the past 2 years of my life, to maybe have an epiphany that, shit, I'm a bad bitch. I don't need this. I don't need this type of negativity in my life. When someone starts bringing you more negativity than positive, happy vibes, that's your time that you need to cut someone off. And I'm done having people walk all over me, take advantage of my kindness, take advantage of my generosity and things that I do for them. And so basically, I'm just covering your feelings. I can promise you something, is that you are someone who's strong and you can overcome whatever obstacle you're going through right now. I can promise you that. You've went how many years of your life? How many years of your life? Happy. Just being yourself. And I can promise you, like in my situation, I'm going away next year. This is my last like full year living in this neighborhood. I'm gonna meet a whole new group of people. I'm gonna start my career. I'm gonna start focusing on my career, on my future. And hopefully one day I'm just gonna be walking down the street. I'm gonna be in the bread aisle at the grocery store. And someone there is gonna ask for my number. Someone there, and I'm just gonna click on the bread aisle. Or maybe we'll click at like, I don't know, the line at Six Flags. Like, you never know where you're gonna meet someone. And honestly, until that day comes, I'm just gonna be focused on myself. Start loving myself like how I should have been for the past 2 years of my life. Once again, if anyone needs someone to talk to vent to call on the phone, please message me. Like, I'm honestly down to help anyone out. I know there was people there for me, but it's really hard to talk to someone when they haven't been through almost the exact thing that I've been through. So, I hope this video helped. Once again, it's not for pity, it's not to bring anyone down, it's not for any of those reasons. It's really just to try to help someone that's been in this situation or is going through the situation right now. So look at yourself in the mirror, like how I'm right now. Tell yourself, I'm a bad bitch. I'm cute. I'm bad. I'm loyal. I'm honest. My mama loves me. My daddy loves me. All my friends love me. And I love myself. So hope you guys have a great night, a great evening, a great minute, a great hour, a great day. And I guess I'll see you guys in my next video. It's gonna be a happy ass video. I'm gonna be dancing again. I'm gonna have cute music on again. And we can all just vibe and be happy once again.